Andres, I want to ask you, who is actually performing the colonoscopy and what is he looking for?
So that's a very good question, Juan. The doctor that performs colonoscopies, it's called an endoscopist. And the endoscopist has a very rigorous training to do this procedure. When you see an endoscopist doing the procedure, somebody that has done quite a bit of these procedures, it can look actually very easy, but these are very technical procedures that you need to make sure you have the proper training. The vast majority of the doctors in the United States doing colonoscopies are gastroenterologists, but we also have a good number of very well-trained surgeons doing colonoscopy. So when we do colonoscopy, what we're looking for, it's a very detailed examination of the lining of the colon. One of the things that we do is to make sure that we reach the very, very beginning of the colon. And the beginning of the colon is the area where the small bowel meets the colon. That area, actually, it's called the terminal ileum, and we know we're there because you can see a valve that it's called ileocecal valve. Nearby, you're going to see the inner part of the appendiceal orifice. So we go all the way down there, we document that we're there, and then that's when we start the study. When we're coming out very slowly, looking at the entire colon, at all the lining, at all the folds. So if you see a polyp, if you see an ulcer, if you see anything that looks abnormal, you can either take it out or you can take a biopsy of it to be looked up under the microscope.
Andres, I completely agree with what you said. It's very important to do a thorough evaluation of the colon. Every time we do an examination, we have to do what's called a retroflexion. That means to look backwards into the rectum, which is the final portion of the colon, in order to look for hidden tumors, look for other lesions such as hemorrhoids, which can cause some symptoms like rectal bleeding or rectal pain.